Oh, that fence looks great.
I'm sure Bella will feel a lot more at home now.
Thanks, Wendy. We'd better get Bella back in her enclosure so I can feed her.
OK. Let's all have a break for lunch, then.
Shh! I'm playing a joke on Scoop. He'll be coming past any moment.
Where's Muck?
He's dumping some soil.
OK, then if everyone's out, let's close things up and leave Bella to have her lunch. Off you go, Bella. Your food is ready for you in your house.
Come on, Bob, let's go and eat our sandwiches. I'm really hungry.
Ooh, what's that? It must be Scoop. 3, 2, 1... Oh, no! Oh, dear! Sorry, Bella!
Mmm, these sandwiches are delicious. Thanks, Wendy.
Oh, good. I can't wait to try them.
Oh, sorry.
Mmm...
The bears can't wait to try them either.
Huh? That's Bella. Sounds like something's wrong.
Come on!
Bella!
It's okay, Bella. I'm sorry. I'm sorry. I didn't mean to frighten you. Oh, no. Please stay there. Ouch!
What's Muck doing in there?
I've really upset Bella. What do I do, Bob?
Don't worry, Muck. We'll get you out.
Muck, go inside Bella's house while we figure out what to do.
Okay. Oh, dear. Oh, Gull. If I were a real elephant, maybe I would know how to make Bella feel better. I see you like Bella's ball too. Hey, I've just had a great idea.
Anything I can do to help, Leo?
Bob's put me in charge of building a giraffe house at the zoo.
A giraffe house? Can I help, Leo? Can I?
Oh, of course, Lofty. I expect it will be a really tall building, so I'll need your help. Come on, the sooner we collect up the materials, the sooner we can get started.
Yay!
Okay, so I need 6 pieces of 2x6.
6? That's not very many.
That's what it says on the plan.
And Bob knows best.
Yes, that's right. He does. And 20 pieces of 2x4, 4 cinder blocks, plywood sheeting, brackets, screws, hinges.
No, that's 4x8.
Oops. Sorry.
Too much to carry. We'll get Tread to help us out.
Did somebody mention my name?
Oh!
Hi, guys!
Hi!
This is so exciting! I've seen Bob's plans and they looked brilliant.
Ah, Bob's the best. So, one giraffe house coming up. Can we build it?
Yes, we can!
All right!
All done. This is one tidy office. I think Wendy will be very impressed.
Sorry, Bob. but I am sorting it out.
Yes, it does look a bit messy. It's like I always say, a workplace needs to be kept tidy.
Oh, is that what you always say, Bob?
Ah, hello, Wendy. I finished the office. Yay!
I've just seen it. Good job.
Thanks. Told you I'd fix it. Hello, Tread. What's up?
I think you'd better come along to the zoo, Bob. We've got a little problem.
Uh-oh.
Is this where the Christmas party's going to be, Bob? Is it?
Yes, Lofty. Mr. Bentley said he would meet us here.
Ah, oh, Bob, there you are at last.
Hello, Mr. Bentley.
I think the party centrepiece should go right here, don't you?
Great idea. We'll build the giant sleigh in no time, Mr. Bentley.
Wonderful. I love Christmas Eve. Oh, and of course, there's all the extra bits to do as well.
Did he say extra bits?
Uh-oh.
And so, we need to arrange the snow scene, the tree, and put up all these lights. I ordered hundreds. This will be the best Christmas party Fixham has ever had, all the way along the seafront as far as the galleon.
That's all going to take some time to put up.
But... it's Christmas, Wendy.
We'll make sure Fixham gets its Christmas party, Mr. Bentley. And it will be the best ever.
Thank you, Bob.
OK, team. Let's get to work. Can we build it?
Yes, we can!
The sleigh looks great, Bob. But what colour will it be?
Well, I was going to paint it red.
Oh, and gold.
Huh?
Yes, can it be red and gold?
Of course. You really do love Christmas, don't you, Mr. Bentley?
Yes, ever since I was a little boy, I've always dreamed of having the best possible Christmas party. Now, we need more snow and more lights.
Wow, Mr. Bentley is so excited.
He is. But then who isn't?
Uh-oh, Mr. Bentley's coming.
Oh, no. Do you think he'll want to change things again?
Oh, Leo!
Ho, 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 Mr. Bentley!
Excellent Christmas spirit, Leo. Now, how about stringing lights from these candy canes right up to the galleon's mast?
We could do that, but we've hung so many already.
Don't worry, we've got plenty more.
Come on, Daisy. You can calm down. I'll count again, but this time I will get past three. One, two, three, four.
Right, that's the heating on. How are you getting on with the pupae, Jenny?
Just finished, Wendy. Oh, no.
What?
I think I've just glued myself to this post by mistake.
Really?
Don't worry, Jenny. There you go. You'd caught your sleeve, that's all.
Thanks, Bob.
Oh, Dizzy will want to see the pupae, won't she?
Oh, yes. I'll go and find her.
17, 18, 19. Ooh, hi, Wendy.
Hi, Dizzy. Dizzy, don't move or say a thing. Understand?
No.
Well, just really, really quietly say okay, okay?
Okay.
A butterfly has landed on your mixing drum.
Oh, that's so...
Shh! Stay still. If it flies off, we may never see it again.
Oh.
Oh, Bob, the They're starting to hatch.
Already? Then we got them in here just in time.
I'll go and get Wendy and Dizzy.
They won't want to miss this.
Jenny, thank goodness. Look. That's a Menelaus blue morpho.
It's one of my butterflies.
How did it... It hatched in Dizzy's drum. Can you catch it and get it inside?
I don't have a net. And anyway, it could fly away any moment. Dizzy, it's up to you to save my butterfly. Can you drive very slowly and carefully back inside?
I'll try, but what if I do not see it?
Dizzy, we can't hear a word you're saying.
I said... What if I'm too noisy and scare it?
We'll just have to hope it doesn't fly off.
I really believe you can do this, Dizzy. Me too. Just pretend the butterfly isn't there.
Okay.
Come on, Dizzy. Slow and steady.
You can do it, Dizzy.
This is absolutely amazing!
Hello, Muck!
Hello,
Hiya.
Muck! We're off to the sports stadium. Sky's got a big surprise for us.
Oh, that's exciting. I'm looking for Tutun, but I can't find him anywhere. Have you seen him?
We passed him at the town hall not long ago. It looked like he was dropping off a big delivery.
Thank you so much, Betsy! See ya!
Oh!
Mind how you go!
Oh, dear me, no.
Hello, Mr. Bentley. I'm looking for Dash Lightning's movie props. Are they in that container, please?
Eh? No. Just dozens of old statues packed in crates of straw.
Oh! Thank you, Mr. Bentley. Bye.
I was expecting new furniture for the town hall. A sofa for the mayor's office. Some lovely, colourful cushions.
I'm never going to find Tutun in time. Now I'll have to tell Bob the bad news.
It's looking great. We're getting there, Wendy.
But we still need to install those props, Bob. And soon.
Ah, there you are, Muck. Any luck?
Oh, Bob, I'm so sorry. I've been looking everywhere, but I still can't find Tutun.
But without that container of props, we can't finish the ride.
I did see one container at the museum and another at the town hall, but they didn't have our props.
Ah, but what was inside them, Muck?
Let's see. Mr. Bentley had statues, but he wanted sofas. And Ish had footballs and sporty stuff, but he wanted statues.
Well, we've got Mr. Bentley's sofas.
That's right, Leo. So, where would all the sporty stuff need to go?
The sports stadium!
Oh! Betsy and the Spring City Rockets were going to the sports stadium. Safi said something about a big surprise.
That could be it. A surprise container of sports equipment. Come on, Muck. Let's go and find out.
Well, this is a surprise, Tutun. Just not quite the one I was expecting.
No, that shouldn't have happened.
Ah, hi, guys.
Hi, Sky. You've probably guessed there's been a big mix-up. Your sports equipment is at the museum.
How did I make such a mistake, Bob?
It's my fault, Tutun. I picked out the wrong container at Roland's.
So, now we know where everything's meant to be. These movie props go to the film studio, the furniture to the town hall, the statues to the museum, and the sports equipment comes here.
Got it, Bob. Now let's pack up that shark and get rolling.
It's manure, Sky. It makes the flowers and, oh, it doesn't matter. I'll just go.
Oh!
It's at the back of my eyes!
Oh, no. It's the Spring City Rockets! I don't want them to smell me as well! I think I'll go the long way round. Maybe if I go fast enough, no one will notice the stinky smell.
Yeah.
Huh?
Gross.
Thanks, Lofty. There we are. That's out of sight, isn't it?
No, I can still see it.
What if we put it right next to the shed? You'll hardly see it at all there.
But I'll still be able to see it a bit.
Don't worry, Mayor Madison. I'm sure we'll find just the right place for it. Up we go again, Lofty.
I think closer.
Here?
No. Further away.
Okay, as long as you're sure.
Oh, no. No.
No.
It'll be over there.
Huh? What?
I think further away.
Oh, no. Closer.
Further away.
Closer.
Oh.
Nearly there. Oh, no. It's Philip. I don't want him to think that I'm stinky. Don't worry, Mum.
Slow down, Muck.
Be careful, Muck.
What on earth is going on?
I'm sorry, Bob. I didn't like it when people thought I was smelly. So I went a really long way round so people couldn't smell me. And then I got late and in a real rush and then I...
It's all right, Mug. It's all right. And you're not smelly. It's just the manure.
Yes, Mug. And we'll give you a good wash when you get back to the yard.
Oh, really?
Yes. And after that, you'll smell as fresh as one of Mayor Madison's roses.
Oh, well. No turnips for me.
Oh, at least the beds for my flowers are still all right.
Here you go, Mr. Bentley.
Thanks, Mark. Oh, and remember to pick me up on your way back, won't you, chauffeur?
Of course. Yes. Back soon! It's me again! We're just taking the materials for the skyscraper.
Muck, wait! You've got the wrong stuff!
Again. Muck just took the materials for Safi's playhouse instead of the ones for the skyscraper station.
I think I'd better call Bob.
These panels are the wrong colour, Bob. We're supposed to be building the red kiosk here.
Oh, dear. Muck must have made a mistake. Hi, Leo.
Bob, there's been a problem with the materials.
I know. We've got the green panels at the stadium station instead of the red ones.
Yeah, and that's not all.
When you get to the next station, you'll have the materials for Safi's playhouse instead of the kiosk.
Okay, thanks, Leo.
I think we'd better go and find Muck and find out what's going on.
Phew! Now I can go and be Mr. Bentley's chauffeur again.
Muck, there you are.
Oh, hello, Bob.
What's going on, Muck? All the materials are in the wrong places.
Really? Are you sure?
Yes, the skyscraper materials are at the stadium station, and these are the materials for Safi's playhouse.
Oh, no. I should never have said I'd be Mr. Bentley's chauffeur.
You said what?
I'm sorry, Bob. Mr. Bentley asked me to help him get to his appointments. I thought I could do both jobs at once.
It is really hard trying to do two jobs at the same time, Muck.
That's why I got in a muddle. Maybe if I do one job at a time, I can still get it all done.
Well, yes. That does seem like a good plan.
If I bring the green materials back here, then take Safi's playhouse back to the yard, then I can pick up the red materials for the stadium station. And then I'll pick up Mr. Bentley.
Can you fix it?
Yes, I can.
kiosks down
and one to go.
OK, Dred. We need to go to the stadium station next.
Stadium station it is. On my way.
Thanks, Lofty. That's it, team. If we all work together, we'll finish building the gingerbread house and have plenty of time to enjoy Christmas Eve.
Rocking out to Christmas carols.
Wrapping presents.
And stacking them neatly under the tree.
Oh, oh, and hunting for chocolate eggs.
That's a different holiday, Muck.
Oh, yeah.
And, of course, giving each other handmade Christmas cards, Wendy.
Oh, yes. I almost forgot.
I've still got the one you made for me last year. A snowboarding elf. Brilliant.
What's an elf, Bob?
Elves make toys, decorate Christmas trees, and help with the delivery of presents.
Ooh, tell me more.
Well, they also wear little green pointy hats.
Oh. Like this.
Let me fix that for you. Yeah, that's better like that.
And what else?
They talk in high-pitched voices.
Like this!
You've got it, Muck.
Look at me! I'm a Christmas elf!
You can't be an elf, Muck. Elves are tiny and nimble and you're a great big dump truck.
Yes, I can, Lofty. I'm Muck the Elf. I'm gonna help make this the best Christmas ever!
Absolutely, Mr. Bentley. The gingerbread house will be ready in time for your Christmas choir concert this evening, I promise.
Music to my ears, Bob. Fa la 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 la. Best be off. My choir needs me. We must practice putting more jingle in our bells. The jingle bells, jingle bells, jingle all the way.
See you later, Mr. Bentley. Okay, team. We can't disappoint Mr. B. Can we build a gingerbread house?
Yes, we can!
Christmas Elf reporting for duty. Need a hand with the gingerbread house, Wendy?
No, thank you, Muck. We're okay here.
Oh. Need any elf help with the snowman, Leo?
Not right now. I'm good, thanks, Muck.
Oh. But how am I supposed to be a Christmas elf if no one needs my help? Oh. Ooh.
Bob's caught up with us, Muck. Can you go and get me the door while I finish the serving counter?
Sure thing, Wendy.
There we go. Our counter is finished.
We've caught up with them, Bob. We might even beat them. Not that it matters at all.
Next thing to do is to put on the door.
I've got the doors right here, Bob. Here you go.
We only need one door, Scoop, but we've got two.
Huh? Oh!
You must have picked up Wendy's door as well by mistake.
Oh, dear! Oh, it'll really slow them down if they don't have it.
Hmm. Can you take it over to her then, please?
Oh! Okay, Bob.
Where's the door? I better tell Bob.
Hi, Wendy! I've got your door.
Thanks, Scoop. That's very helpful. Have you joined our team?
Huh? Oh, no, it's just that I picked up your door by mistake.
Hi, Bob. I can't find the door for our hot dog stand. Do you know where it is?
Yes, Muck. Scoop's got your door. He's taking it to Wendy now.
Thanks, Bob. Hey? Why has Scoop got our door?
He really wants us to be the first to finish our stand.
Oh, so you mean he hid our door. But that's not fair.
And he got muddled up and brought me your door by mistake. Muck?
That's our door, Scoop. It's not nice to hide other people's things.
I didn't hide it, Muck.
Yes, you did. You took our door because you want to win the race. Bob told me.
No, that's not true. Come with me and Bob can tell you what really happened.
Don't go away with our door again. It's not fair.
Oh, no. I didn't mean to do that. Really, I didn't. Here, have it. Whoa! Oops. I'll catch it. Oh, no.
Oh, no.
Uh-oh.
No, Scoop!
Oh. You'll have to rebuild this whole wall, Bob.
And you'll need a couple of brand new wood panels. These two are broken.
I'm sorry, Wendy. I didn't mean to damage your stand.
Don't worry, Scoop. It was an accident.
I know, but Bob said to work slowly and steadily. I wanted to win the race to build the hot dog stand so much, I wasn't slow or steady.
It wasn't a real competition, Scoop. It was just Wendy and me having a bit of fun.
Oh.
Scoop, you can dig the path from the car park over there to the start of the walkway.
Fantastismo! It's going to be the most amazing park ever!
Glad to hear it.
Yeah! Amazing Scoop! Looking good. Yep, nice sharp sides. Same depth all the way along. Now get it all nice and even and no gravel spilled over the sides. Yes! Amazing Scoop does it again.
Or some.
Ooh, this is a nice path, Scoop.
Thanks, Lofty. Oh, it's just what I do, you know. Do you think Dash will notice how good it is?
You can show him yourself.
Dash is here.
Yep, just over.
Ah, he is!
Dash Lightning.
Dash Lightning.
Bob the Builder, the man who can.
Hi, Dash.
Wow, this is gonna be some walkway. I'll be back shortly to see you fix up my nameplate, but I have to see Sky first. Don't finish before I get back, will you?
Oh, don't worry, Dash. We'll still be here.
Well, Dash Lightning.
Oh, no!
What?
Dash is talking to Stretch.
And?
I wonder what they're talking about.
Hey, Dash, I can't believe I'm talking to you.
The honor is all mine, Stretch. Zoom! Boom! Dash Lightning loves his fans.
My friend Scoop over there. He's your biggest fan.
He's looking at me. I have to do something amazing.
He's an amazing digger. Do you want to see his work?
I really do, Stretch. But later. Right now, I have to zoom-a-boom-zoom. Love your work, guys!
Ah! He's coming this way! I have to do something amazing! Like... Yes! I'll lift all that timber! Hurry, Scoop, hurry! Oh, no, Dash is going! Hoppa! Amazing, Scoop! Whoa! No, don't fall! Help! My world is slipping! I'm stuck! I'm really stuck.
Right, where's the timber for the walkways, Wendy?
It should be over here. That's odd. There's some here, but not nearly enough.
What?
Hold on, Bob. There's a piece over there.
Here's another. And another. And another.
Who wants to share a garage anyway, Lofty? I mean, I'd rather be on my own, really, instead of having someone get in my way all the time.
That's not what you were saying before, Dizzy. Before, you were saying how much fun it would be.
Well, it won't be now, will it? Because Shift has spoilt everything.
I don't think that's fair, Dizzy.
Thanks, Lofty.
It's not that Shifter doesn't want to share it with you.
Huh?
He's just upset because he thought he was getting his own garage.
Oh. And it was me that got his hopes up in the first place, wasn't it? Oh, you're right, Lofty. This isn't Shifter's fault at all.
Dizzy, did Shifter bring over that new box of bolts? I need it now.
Yes. Yes, he did, Bob, but he's still carrying it round with him.
Right. I'll have to go and get it. Hi, Wendy. Is Shifter okay?
Oh, I'm afraid not. He's hiding in the gravel store. He won't talk and he won't come out.
We'll have to try and put this right somehow. And then we need to get the garages finished.
Bob, could I try talking to Shifter again? I wasn't very kind to him just now and I really would like to share with him.
Thank you, Dizzy. That's very sweet of you.
Yes, it really is. Bob and I should have explained everything to Shifter before we started. But I'm sure you're the best one to talk to him.
Come on then, let's see what we can do.
I'm sorry I was cross, Shifter.
Go away, please, Dizzy. I don't want to talk to anyone right now.
I didn't mean what I said about not wanting to share with you. I really do want to share. And I love the idea of one red wall and one that's green with orange round it.
You mean like I want for my garage?
Yes. And I've got a brilliant butterfly poster up, but there's room for another, so we could have a Dash Lightning poster too.
Like Mock's?
Yes! Dash Lightning's so amazing. We can play Dash Lightning games. What does he say? Zoom! Boom!
Lightning strikes twice! I know lots of Dash Lightning games.
Will you teach them to me?
Okay. Bob, can you and Wendy paint Dizzy's garage today?
We certainly can, Shifter. Just as soon as you've given me those bolts.
Oops.
And we finished building the new garages.
Yay! Let's do it!
Look up there! It's like the snow's made a kind of cliff. That looks really cool!
Oh, yeah, it does. Anyway, it's time I got back to Wendy.
No, wait, hold on, Trent. Watch me first. I want to do a spin like the one you just did.
Still think you can be king of the road, do you? Off you go, then. Surprise me.
I will. Watch this. Here comes a really mega super skid!
Oh, was that it?
No, no. Stay there, Trent. That was just a practice. Right, here comes the real thing.
Go on, then. Last chance.
Oh, no! Get out of the way, Trent! 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 Can you hear me?
I'm over here, Scoop.
Oh, thank goodness. Are you okay?
Well, kind of.
Oh, dear. I can't move. I'm completely stuck.
Hold on. I'll pick you out. I'm sorry, Trent. There's loads of snow. This is going to take ages.
But you won't be able to get all the way over here without snow chains anyway, Scoop. Find Wendy. She'll know what to do.
Yes, OK. Good idea. I won't be long.
Quick as you can, though, eh? It's really cold in here.
Wendy! Wendy! Help!
What is it?
Wendy, there's been an avalanche.
An avalanche? Where? And where's Tred?
Tred's been buried down this hill. The avalanche just came whooshing down and buried him. And I couldn't dig him out because I haven't got snow chains.
It's all right, Scoob. It's all right. Don't worry. You did the right thing not to try. We don't want you getting stuck too.
Hi, Wendy.
Hi, Bob. We've got an emergency on Observatory Hill. We need to stretch here as quickly as possible.
We're on our way.
Poor Tred, I hope he's all right.
Wendy says he's very cold and very stuck, but not hurt.
Oh, well, that's good.
With your track stretch, you should be able to get across the snow and dig him out.
Oh, I'll do my best, Bob.
Could you hurry up, please? I'm a bit, Is it over there?
Oh, yeah, I know. Here we are.
Oh, come on, come on, come on.
There you go.
Cheers, Leo.
No worries.
Right.
Oh, not the phone again. Don't answer it.
Hi, Chef Tutty.
Oh.
Is everything okay?
I'm not sure, Bob. Do you have any idea where Trev is?
Yes, he's here with me.
Could you ask him to get to the sushi bar as soon as he can, or my fish could go off and be ruined?
I'll tell him right away, Chef. Bye.
Yeah, okay, great, Bob. Bye. I've got to roll.
No, wait, Trev. Come back. Chef Tatty's waiting for you at the sushi bar. He said something about some fish going off.
I know, the fish. Gotta go, Bob.
No.
Ah, Tred, there you are.
Sorry I'm late, Chef Tatty.
No worries. Well, actually, I was starting to get a wee bit worried about my fish. It doesn't smell off. In fact, it doesn't smell at all. Huh? What are these?
What's wrong now?
Tiles?
Oh, dear. If you've got the tiles, then what has Bob got?
Huh? Uh-oh. Hello?
Have you got a box there with my fish in it, Bob?
No, I've just opened it, and I appear to have a control panel.
So who's got my fish?
Oh, no.
Hello?
Hi, Wendy. It's Chef Tatty. Are you by any chance staring at a fish? What on earth's going on?
Sir Bob, you've got the control panel and Chef Tatty has the tiles.
And Wendy has the fish, which will be spoiled soon if it isn't refrigerated.
And someone still needs to pick up Leo in the cupboard and drop them off at the sushi bar.
I'm sorry, Bob. I should have told you. I was getting too busy.
It's not your fault, Tred. Wendy and I should have picked up the right boxes.
Well, I still try to do too much, and I wouldn't let anyone help.
Oh.
Oh, no! Not more! And I promised to be so careful.
Right, that's the roof finished. Now for the timber cladding.
Oh. Huh? Who's been eating those? Flame? What are you doing here? Oh no, Flame, it's you who's been knocking down the apples. Stop! Flame! Come back! Flame! Come back! Stop!
Muck, but I'd better make sure Flame stays on her side of the fence from now on.
Oh, no! There are apples everywhere, and it's all my fault.
Why is it your fault, Muck?
Because I chased Flame. Because she was eating apples. Because I broke her fence. Because I'll show you. I thought I'd knocked down all the apples and I didn't want to upset Chef Daddy. So I put them here.
Oh, Muck, it was Flame. Once she got into the orchard, she knocked down most of them.
But if you'd told us, instead of hiding the apples, we might have realised it was Flame's fault sooner.
Then I'm not going to hide things anymore. I'll give these to Chef Tattoo.
I'm not sure he'll be able to use those, Muck.
Oh, but I still want to show him.
Well, he'll arrive soon, so we need to fix the damage to the barn.
Oh, oh no!
Oh!
Get off! Get off! I can't shake it loose!
What's happening down there?
Bob, I accidentally hit the power box in the maintenance garage and now all the garage doors have closed. And Scoop and Muck are trapped.
Trapped?
And now I've broken the scaffold tower, so you're stuck on the roof too.
I can reach you.
It's too dangerous with that bit of scaffold jammed on your hook, Lofty.
Oops.
Oh, I don't know what I did to make such a mess.
Maybe you were working a little too fast without taking enough care, Shifter.
Well, we need to think fast about how to get down from up here.
We could use a ladder. But those are all stuck in the garages too.
Could we build a ladder? Or a staircase or something?
That's not a bad idea, Shifter. Perhaps you could use some of those empty pallets you cleared away.
Yes, I could do that. But I'll need help.
I can't help you, Shifter.
Oh, no. Oh, but I know someone who can. Tread, it's an emergency. I need your help to move the pallets back to the yard again. Come on!
I'd love to, Shifter. I really would, but there's one problem. I'm surrounded.
Oh, yes, I see. Sorry. Here.
Right, young Shifter, here I am. Start loading me up.
That's the idea, Shifter.
Not so fast, Shifter. Take it easy.
OK, Tread. Now I'll move yours. It's working. Back in the boat, Bob. We'll have you down in no time. That's it, Bob. I've used all of the pallets.
Thanks, Shifter. Let's go, Wendy.
Ooh, do be careful, both of you.
We're almost there, but we need two more steps to get down.
Yes! I know what to do!
Push the blade of your bucket underneath, Muck.
Like this?
Yes, that's right. As far as you can. OK, are you ready to lift?
Yes, I think so.
Right, on three. Three, lift! Yes! Now we have to move it. I'll come forward, you reverse, OK?
OK. Take it slowly, Scoop. Ready?
Now!
Yay! Look, we're moving it!
Two?
Yes, you worked together really well there because you listened to each other.
I bet Shifter could lift that stone up really easily.
I don't think so, Scoop. It's very heavy.
Where is Shifter? He seems to have disappeared.
It's not like Shifter to go off on his own. He doesn't know his way around Spring City. We'd better go and find him. Wendy, Stretch, please would you stay here in case he comes back?
Okay, Bob.
Will do.
The rest of us will search the city. Right, team? Can we find him?
Yes, we can!
first. That's better. I'm coming! Oh! Oh! Can anyone hear me? Oh!
Schiffer is really fast, and we've looked everywhere.
Where else can he be?
Help! Oh, help me, someone! Can anyone hear me?
Hold on. Did you hear that?
Hello?
Huh?
Schiffer here. I'm stuck.
He's behind that hill. Quick, let's go!
Help me! Oi! Please help!
We're here, Schiffer! Schiffer, what happened?
Are you trying to be a digger or something?
It's not funny, Scoop. I'm really stuck. Can you help me get the right way up?
Why don't you pull your forks out?
Because I can only move them up and down. And when I do that, this happens.
Oh, I can't control it, Bob. Wow! Oh! Oh, no!
I can't hold it.
Here comes the mistress! Ow.
Yay! Well done, Scoop. That was your big moment.
Well done.
My camera drone! Oh, no!
Did you get any of that?
Oh, no.
I am so sorry. I've ruined everything.
Don't worry, Lofty. We can get a replacement panel for the fence from the yard.
And this section of the gateway is cracked just here. We'll need to replace it.
OK. Scoop and I can pick up a new one of those too.
My drone is broken, but the camera's OK, thank goodness.
Hooray! The camera still works!
Why did you lift with such a long hoist in this wind, Lofty?
I was trying to get away from the drone. I don't like being filmed. I'm just a bit shy, I suppose.
I'm sorry, Lofty. I'll keep you out of shot from now on. And, Bob, I won't need you to do any more talking.
Really?
I'm afraid so. You're, not really a natural on camera.
Phew! That's a relief.
What?
The truth is, Lofty, I don't like being on camera either. Especially talking on camera.
Well, hey, I'm not the only one!
So, who is going to be on camera explaining what's going on? Hey?
Actually, Scoop, I think I know who'd make a great replacement.
At last! I am ready for my big Huh?
What do you think, Wendy?
Can I film you?
Yes, you can!
Yes, you can.
Right, team. Today we're going to be building an exercise trail.
We'll be building five places where people can stop and do keep fit exercises at different areas around this park.
So, we're going to start... Hi, Sky.
Hiya, team Bob. Everyone revved up and ready to build the exercise trail?
Yes.
That's the sporting spirit.
But how will people know what exercises to do, Sky?
Well, signs like this will show people what to do. See? This shows someone walking along a balance beam like this one.
Ah.
But why are we building them in different places and not all together in the same place?
So people can run from one exercise to the next, Dizzy.
It really gets you puffing and panting and your muscles working.
Wow! And people can do all this?
Of course! People can do anything if they try. You should always push yourself to the limits and never be scared to try something new.
Wow. I would love to try something new. Do something I've never done before.
Anyway, I'm running to Riverdale and back today. And after that, I can try out the exercise trail. I can't wait! See you later!
Right, team, you heard Skye. She'll be back later and we've got an exercise trail to build.
And I have to find something to do that I've never done before.
Can we build it?
Yes, we can!
I've drilled all the holes at the other sites, ready for the rest of the build, Bob.
Great. Thanks, Scoop. Have you finished that chin-up bar, Leo?
Yes, Bob. I'm just going to give it a quick test.
Go, Leo!
That's the sporting spirit. Right. So, we've got the press-ups and the monkey bars to do next.
And then we'll finish off with the parallel bars.
Scoop, as you finish the holes, Leo can help you put your rear bucket back on now.
Will do.
No problem, Bob.
Oh, no! Oh, no! The hoops! Now what have I done?
Roley, what's going on?
I've crashed into the dugout and I've ruined the basketball hoops.
It's not like you to make a mistake, Roley. What happened?
I was too busy thinking about my speech and all the people who will be coming.
Don't worry, Roley. We can fix the dugout.
And we can replace the poles for these hoops.
But Betsy's here with the rockets and other people will start turning up soon. They'll see what a mess I've made.
Betsy hasn't picked the rockets up from swimming yet. She just came to say she'd like to hear your speech too.
Oh, no. Not another one. I'll never be able to relax with all those people and machines watching me.
They might be watching you, Roley, but you don't have to watch them.
But what if I forget what building we've done? I'll feel really silly.
You won't forget because Bob can remind you.
Can I?
How?
Bob can give you hand signals to remind you about everything we've done. Raking, rolling and line painting. See?
That's a great idea, Wendy.
It certainly is. Now, can we fix it?
Yes, we can!
After all the gravel was packed down, we moved on to stage four, the asphalt. Which Bob and Wendy spread out using rakes. And I, rolled nice and flat, like this. In stage five, Bob and Wendy painted the lines which mark out the court. Then, finally, they put up two new basketball hoops. And that is the end of my speech.
Well done!
Brilliant! Yeah.
Well done! Brilliant, Roley!
That was great! Thanks, Roley!
I really, really, really want to be a builder now.
Thanks, Safi. But I only remembered what to say because Bob was giving me hand signals.
But I only gave you two signals. You did all the rest yourself.
Really? Did I? Wow!